Mary, welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
Look gorgeous. I love that you're here together. This is
yeah.
I love this booking. I know, so I'm so excited about this.
Great fun for us to do together.
Well, I mean, in addition to working together, I don't know if anyone knows you, but you're also married to each other in real life. So yeah. So yeah. This is...
We get to practice. Every morning, you know, we've been practicing.
Yeah, you're really method actors.
We're so method. We take it
methoding
really seriously.
Yeah. I want to talk about the new series, The Gentleman in Moscow, but first, I want to talk Star Wars.
Oh, yeah.
Because you both have Star Wars in common. Is it fun that you're both very involved in the Star Wars universe? I mean, is that
weird?
Is it cool? I mean, that's bizarre, right?
It's somewhat bizarre,
but it's very nice.
It's bizarre in that it's just amazing that it happened, you know, because it's like such a cool thing to be a part of.
Did you give any tips on what it's like to be on set or?
No. Did I?
No. I mean, no tips, but you know, I got to sort of see how much fun it was for him to do it. And I think you just talked to me about how special it is to get to kind of be a part of something that means so much to so many people. I mean, Star Wars fans are like heartfelt fans, and I think it's incredibly special to get to.
Can we be seeing maybe a second season of Obi-Wan or Ahsoka?
I think Ahsoka is gonna happen. Well, we think so. It's in development, it's being written right now.
Great!
You know, that's very
congratulations,
exciting.
That'll be good.
Thanks, that'll be great.
I don't know. For me, I have no news to tell. I'm waiting for the call.
All right, here, yeah.
But I don't know that it's happening. Who knows?
Do you guys have Star Wars merch all over the house?
We have a little bit.
A little bit.
We have a little. It creeps in, you know.
Like there are. There's a couple of Obi-Wan dolls that our son Laurie calls Daddy. Like.
Yeah. Yeah. It's just like, oh, hi, Daddy.
Who's this? Daddy.
Yeah.
That's right.
That's pretty cool.
That's it, yeah.
And he's into Obi-Wan?
Yeah.
How
he's really into Grogu, who doesn't appear in either of our series.
No, thanks a lot.
You're gonna have to talk to the kid about
this.
He
loves that, yeah.
He loves his favorite.
He met the real Grogu.
On my set, Ewan came to visit me at work.
I mean, Baby Yoda is the cutest thing I've ever seen in my life.
There was a big build-up to it, because he's got several Grogu stuffed animals that he loves. I mean, since he was born to now, he loves them. He wants to take them everywhere.
Of course.
So we were like, Laura, you're gonna meet the real Grogu. And he was like a year and a half at this point. And the team, like the real, everybody was there to make this happen, to like bring Grogu to life in front of him.
Oh my gosh.
It went really badly.
He freaked out.
He freaked out?
He lost it, yeah.
Well, that's like his, it's like meeting like his first celebrity, right?
Yeah, he did not like it.
It was too weird.
It was too realistic?
Too much, too weird.
That's hilarious. Yeah.
Screaming, the puppeteers were like, oh, sorry. It's like screaming his head off.
Speaking of Star Wars, you and your daughter posted a fun video of her with an Obi-Wan Kenobi toothbrush. Did you see this?
No.
She was staying at the house or staying at your house, and she was looking for an extra toothbrush, and the only spare toothbrush, the only clean, like, was an Obi-Wan toothbrush, and it's her dad. But watch this video, it's funny.
It won't stop.
Goodbye, old friend. May the force be with you. I have work to do. May the force be with you.
How fun is that? She's funny.
Did she get the music too?
Yeah, isn't that great? She's funny.
Did she edit that? That's edited, right?
She's good. Amazing.
She's really good. Let's talk about A Gentleman in Moscow. By the way, you have an unbelievable mustache in this, I will say.
Oh, yeah.
Here's Ewan's mustache.
It's
Ewan as the Count. That's fantastic.
Yeah. Really good.
And is it a fake mustache?
No, it's mine. I've had them in the past where we've done it probably here, stuck on things.
We've done it.
We did it, didn't we?
We did a bunch of sketches. Yeah.
But a stick-on mustache is a nightmare. So you get it in the morning, the first thing you do is shave to make it clean, and then they shove glue all over that freshly shaved lip, which is horrible.
Yes.
And then all day you've got to keep this mustache from... Sort of from pinging off, you don't really move your face. And I thought, this job is like 6 months long. I can't have that experience for 6 months. So I just grew my own, and it's a monster, as you can see.
It's very impressive. Yeah. And how long did you have to have the mustache for?
Well, we had an actor strike in the middle of the show, so for a year and a half.
Oh my God!
A year and a half.
Did you like his mustache?
For the first few months, I did.
Then, well, you just didn't.
And then the novelty kind of wore off, I think, a little bit. Yeah. But I always I love you with any facial hair. So you know, I do.
No, the truth is, that looks great because the Count has dark hair and a dark, and it looks cool. Like, if you had a moustache, it would look really cool. My moustache is very blonde and sort of yellowy white. And so in my real life, I've got this sort of like, people are, has he got a moustache? Or, you know, it's not really present. Anyway.
I thought it'd be fun if we all just tried on
moustaches
now. If you want, then you can have one.
This one?
Yeah, like, you can have...
I feel like this is like a good color for me.
I think it's perfect
color
for you,
Okay.
Oh, yeah. That looks good.
You look great.
Is it really?
Oh, my God.
Wow. Hey, guys. Kids. Hey, knock it off. Bring it up.
Sorry. I just wanted to know what that
was
like.
You found it very attractive. Yeah, you did. The series is great. You're both fantastic in it. You want to tell everybody what a Gentleman in Moscow is about and who you play?
The Gentleman in Moscow, well, okay, it's a very, very well-loved novel.
Yes.
And by Amor Toulouse. And it's about, it's set just after the revolution, the 1921 revolution in Russia. And my character is a count, a member of the aristocracy. And the aristocracy were wiped out during this revolution. They killed everybody. And this count is allowed, he's spared because he's believed to have written a somewhat communistic poem in 1917, which he actually didn't write, but they spare him and they sentence him to house arrest in the hotel that he lives in. At the moment he lives, has a suite of rooms in the Metropole Hotel on Red Square, and they sentence him to house arrest in that hotel. So for the next 40 years, the story takes place within the walls of the hotel and he's never allowed to leave.
Wow.
And it's a story of great love and heart, and it's a beautiful, beautiful story.
And Mary, who do you play?
I play Anna Urbanova, who was a Russian film actress, very, very fabulous character, who was so much fun to play, who has a kind of, you know, liaison, romantic liaison with the Count that grows over time, over the course of 30 years, into like a real love. And so it was so much fun to get to play that with my actual love.
No. I want to show a clip. Here's Ewan McGregor and Mary Elizabeth Winstead in A Gentleman in Moscow. Take a look.
Your four-legged friends will not be joining us?
They shan't. But I see your two-legged one shall be. Is this your daughter?
Him?
No.
No.
I don't know who this is. Shall we go somewhere else?
The Hotel Britannia has a fantastic restaurant.
He's not allowed to leave the hotel because he's a criminal.
All right, Nina.
And a danger to the
Nina, that's enough. Thank you.
So you do know her?
Hardly at all.
More than I would like.
Room 317. Give me 20 minutes.
Ewan McGregor, Mary Elizabeth Winstead, everybody. A Gentleman in Moscow premieres March 29th on Paramount+. Evan Rachel Wood joins us after the break. Stick around, everybody.